Hello, party people. This is Michele Lamberti speaking. Welcome to the new game of the day. This one is going to be another Queen's Gambit declined. And this one is going to be Reshevsky with white against black, played by Fischer. Reshevsky was one of the best players of the 50s and 60s. And okay, Fischer is well known. This game was played in Los Angeles in 1961. So Fischer wasn't at his peak, no, if you want to call it this way. He was 20 years old, and he still had a lot to learn. He wasn't the Fischer of 1970, 1972. But nonetheless, a very interesting game. Okay, let's start the game. Reshevsky played d4, Fischer played d5, something that he later dropped and went for knight to f6. Okay, Reshevsky played knight f3. We see knight f6 by black, and Reshevsky goes for the usual c4. We see e6, and bishop knight to c3, and here Fischer played bishop b4, the Ragusin variation, which is a very active variation for black. E3, black castles, and white plays bishop d3, and here black plays knight to c6, and the idea is that after a3, and after you capture him, you can play knight to a5, so you're attacking c4, and you're preparing c5, so it's you go for an active play. You don't want to have your cramped structure that you sometimes get with the Queen's Gambit. And here Reshevsky played the good move. He played knight to d2, and the idea is that after castle, you play f2, f3, with the idea of controlling e4, and at some point you want to push your e4 pawn. And the idea behind it is that you grab space in the center, you have protect e4, but since white has the bishop here and black doesn't, you want to open up the position, because with open lines and open files, it always it's always an advantage for the side that has the bishop pair. So here the idea of playing d2, knight to d2 is very good, and also you over protect c4. Black here goes for the usual c5 push. He has to play active, and white castles. And now black plays b6, and the idea is not to play bishop b7, but to play the bishop to a6. And so that if there's a capture here on d5, you can exchange the d3. So black wants to get rid of the bishop pair of white, so bishop pair, which is a sensible strategy. White isn't having enough of it. He plays c2 d5, and black captures back with the pawn, and now comes the aforementioned f3 push. Black tries to counter, and white goes to with his rook to e1, and we see bishop e6. This position is equal. Nothing much really happened. The strategy is clear for both sides. White wants to go with the center and then with the king attack, and black is trying to get some counterplay on the queen side. We see a bad move by Reshevsky. This was unnecessary. Play rook a2, but okay. Black plays rook to c8, and white tries to restructure his knight. He goes to f1. Pardon me. We see recapture and capture here on d4, and black is trying to start a kingside attack. Yeah. Okay, and now White played his rook to f2, trying to get him on the better on a better position, because after he plays a4 and he captures, then he would have an open f5. As you can see, basically here all the pieces are aiming at the black king. And yeah, okay, black is trying to get some counterplay on the c5. Just a moment. He's threatening here to capture here, so he's not only connecting his rooks, but he's also threatening to capture here on h3 and go for an attack. Okay, but the position is still equal. Okay, here white goes for the breakthrough, e4, and after the capture, white plays f2, e4, and we see the open f file. Okay, the center is a little bit loose here with the hanging pawns, but okay, at this point, white was going for an attack, so he doesn't care about those technicalities. Okay, after this move, black basically now is trying to get into white's position, coming from the king side, pardon me, from the queen side, where he has strong pieces, and this piece is strong, this piece is strong, and he's trying to counter the attack in the center with an attack on the flank. Okay, we see knight to a to b3. Basically now you have to give up one of your bishops, and okay, black now marches on, pardon me, white now marches on. As you can see, yes, here this great diagonal, he has pressure against f7, and yeah, black's attack is not really going anywhere. And okay, he played queen to g5. Now black has to be very precise here and to the defend. And okay, he played here bad move. He played rook to c6. The problem is that this move here, bishop g5, wasn't really. Black had no way to really avoid this. The problem is that, okay, you can capture here on a3. But, okay, let's look at if you don't capture, let's look at queen to e6, then you can simply take. And you can. And you capture here the pawn, and yeah, black has no compensation at all. I mean, he will get crushed on the king side. Maybe ideas like bishop f6 and yeah, all that stuff. You know, it's completely attack going on. And if we compare the king safety, you know, this king is safe, and this king is basically attacked by three pieces. So it's pretty clear to see where this is going. But Fischer was in time trouble, so he didn't play the best move. It would have been to play queen to e6. He captured on a3, overlooking this move. And after this move, he resigned. So this was one of Fischer's bad losses. Basically losing the game, time trouble. But okay, this wasn't the Fischer of the 70s. And okay, let's look at this final position. There's nothing you can do. You either lose your rook here, or black just white just takes here. And let's see, maybe we can try. I mean, you cannot really afford to lose this rook. So let's try this thing here. Then I guess this move. And let's try this one. Yeah, it really is not something that you want to play on. Let's look at the engine, what the engine would do here. Okay, after this one he wants... Okay, let's look at this one. Okay, as I said, he wants to capture. Okay, King H7 seems to be better. Okay, and I guess now, yeah, okay, this is the killer blow. You just have this this rook lift. Yeah, this is over. Okay, one of the rare losses of Fischer. Yeah, Rushevsky was a very strong player at that time. And yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, basically Fischer lost his game in time trouble. And yeah, but the record scene evaluation, it gives you a little bit more counterplay with Black, and it's not that complicated as a Marana variation. So if you want to play the Queen's Gambit declined, I would urge you to look at the Rogozin variation, and I would urge you to study this maneuver after Rushevsky played knight from f3 to d2, because this is a basic idea that you not only see in the Rogozin variation, but in many other variations where white plays knight to d2, then f3 with the idea of countering and playing e4, which is a very strong idea. Black has to be very careful here. So I would urge you to study this maneuver. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye.